That's a funny face. Okay, what's the question? Quizmaster. Quizmaster with the questions.
What did the Wicked Witch of the West write in the sky over the Emerald City?
That's a question.
An entertainment question.
Yeah, well, that's from The Wizard of Oz, isn't it? So, Dorothy had to kill the witches, right?
So, yeah, the Wicked Witch of the West, and must have got flattened by a house.
One of the witches got flattened by a house. But what? No, it couldn't have been that witch because she got flattened by a house at the beginning. It must have. What did she write in the sky? I don't know. Kill, death, end. I don't know. Okay, what did she write in the sky?
Surrender, Dorothy.
Well, I see. I wouldn't have got that. Okay. I'm not going to do very well, I don't think, but let's try again. Next one.
Who starred with Mae West in My Little Chickadee?
I have no idea. Rock Hudson.
W.C. Fields.
W.C. Fields. See, I couldn't tell you anything about that. Okay, these are all Western cultural iconic questions designed for the older generation. Anyway, give me another one. Maybe I'll know something.
Whose radio show does Domaine, the social worker, appear in?
A radio show with a social worker? I don't know. I guess I have to, I don't even know any radio shows because I don't listen to the radio.
Except for the songs back in Scotland. When I had that old radio that I don't know, must have been 40 or
yeah.
60 years old, but still works.
Yeah, some of the old technology is still cool because it still works. Some of the new technology just falls apart. Right. I don't know. I'm going to say Hancock's Half Hour, but that's because it's the only thing that I've ever heard of. I don't know. What's the answer?
Steve Wright.
Ah, Radio 1 DJ. I used to listen to Steve Wright when I took the bus to school. Anyway. See, I should have known that.
What was the name of the eagle that escaped from Regent's Park Zoo in 1965?
I'm supposed to know the eagle that escaped from a zoo in 1965.
A park zoo.
Yeah, that's in London. Regent's Park is in London. Take the canal through London. You actually go through the middle of the zoo. It's kind of interesting. Anyway, I don't know. Peter. I don't know what his name was.
The answer is
Lofty or something weird like that.
Close. Your second guess was close.
Okay.
Goldie.
Goldie, and I said Lofty. Well, there you go. Goldie the Eagle, right? Goldie is probably Golden Eagle, right, I suppose. Okay, one more question. I'm doing terribly.
Who did Elizabeth II succeed to the British throne?
I guess it wasn't Elizabeth I. Elizabeth II. Okay, that's the present queen, isn't it, Elizabeth II? So, following the Second World War, I should know that. George V. Some weird things going on.
King George V, I think?
That's what I said, George V. Oh. Got something right.
How many presidential likenesses are carved in Mount Rushmore? Rushmore.
Oh, that's easy. That's four. Four presidents carved there. Four. Hello, darling. How's it going?
Fine.
Super cool.
What does a double O indicate in 007?
License to kill. Yes. Thank you very much. Oh, it's two out of two. Two in a row, I mean. Not two out of two, two in a row. Okay, give me another one. See if I can get three in a row.
Who wrote the wistful line?
Oh, you're not wearing any clothes. To hide you behind the bananas.
Who wrote the wistful line? Oh, to be in England now that April's here.
Yeah, you have to hide you behind the bananas and the toilet roll. Who wrote which line?
Who wrote the wistful line? Oh, to be in England now that April's here.
I don't know, Wilfred Owen. I thought it was probably Lord Byron or something like that.
Robert Browning.
Wasn't he married to Elizabeth Barrett Browning, or was that somebody else in history? So my knowledge of history was absolutely terrible because I didn't learn anything in my British school because the school system sucks. Spent all my time studying in the history class about cavemen. Know nothing about Scottish history. It's pointless and useless. If you want to learn something proper, learn it yourself. Teach yourself. That's the only way to learn, is teach yourself. Or seek out a master and learn from them.
What Spanish and English writers died on the same day, April the 23rd, 1616?
I don't know. Shakespeare and Cervantes. I don't know. I don't even know if that's close.
Miguel and Cervantes and William Shakespeare.
Whoa!
Miguel de Cervantes.
I was right. Cervantes and Shakespeare. I got it right. Okay, give me one more. One more. We'll do one more. I'm not as thick as I think I am.
What is a nanosecond?
Well, it's obviously a very, very, very small part of a second. A millionth of a second.
A millionth of a second.
Oh, give me another one. I'm on a roll here. I'm on a roll.
What type of weather is normally brought on by anticyclone?
Oh, brown.
A depression.
Fine weather.
Ah. Anticyclones bring fine weather. Okay, one more.
What drug was introduced commercially? Commercially by Bayer AG Leverkusen, Germany, in 1899.
Penicillin. Aspirin. That kind of thing.
Aspirin.
Oh, I'm on a roll.
You said penicillin, even though it was
So is she breaking things over there? Right.
You said penicillin, but it was...
I said penicillin or aspirin, which is the same thing, basically.
You
can
choose one.
I peed.
I mean, you peed. Where?
In the kitchen.
You mean the kitchen?
Oh.
Where? Who battled for the World Chess Championship at Reykjavik,
is it?
You just got Reykjavik, Iceland, in
1972, the World Chess Championship. So it probably needs two names. It's got to be an American and a Russian. So it's going to be Bobby Fischer and... It's the only one you know, Kasparov, yeah. He's probably about 7 years old at the time. I don't know. Even Kasparov's still alive today. Bang! Okay, we're going to say Fischer and Kasparov. I thought it's probably the other Russian. But,
I'm making a power cell you got.
Bobby Fischer and Boris Spassky.
See, I said it was the other Russian. It would have been too easy to be Kasparov. But I got half of it right. Okay, one more. Because I'm doing okay.
What were ivories to an old West gambler?
Ivories to an old West gambler. They weren't piano keys, obviously. Ivories. Ivories to an old West gambler. What did they gamble with? Cards? What else did they gamble with?
Dice.
Ah, smart. I'll go with Mummy's answer. Mummy's answer was good. Dice, of course.
Dice.
Yeah, I didn't get that one. I thought I'd...
What did a pack of cards not include until 1857?
I don't know. Jokers.
Jokers, I would say, yeah.
Jokers.
Okay, one more. This is all throw everything on the floor, shall we?
Happens.
Bang! Okay, let's go. Let's do one more because.
Really?
Trivial Pursuit card. You don't need a board for Trivial Pursuit. It's pointless having a board. Just ask the questions. What a great way to learn how to read as well.
Anyway. What country's flag flies over Spitsbergen?
There's actually a place called Spitsberg.
That's mountain range.
Is it?
I think.
Spitsbergen is a mountain range. The Swiss flag?
Yeah.
See, I have no idea.
Germany, Switzerland, some Germanic language.
Well, it's got to be Europe because it's Berg, right?
It's got to be a Germanic language spoken here, so it's going to be...
Yeah, but you've got Edinburgh, which is kind of... Anyway, never mind.
But the Spitz is Germanic. Spitz means...
Peak.
Pointy.
Spitz means pointy.
Well, I don't know if it means pointy, but it means something in that.
The peak of something, the top
pointy
of something.
Bird? Yeah, something like that.
Okay. An American swimmer called Mark Spitz would have been Mark Pointy. Okay. Mark something pointy.
Ready?
I'm going to say Switzerland, but that was with Mummy's help, because I wouldn't probably have guessed that. Ooh! You're not wearing any clothes. Okay. This is last answer. So check it out, read it out.
I'm bringing this.
And you do a Norway. Answer.
Norway. Oh, of course. Even though I had no idea.
What's the only color Johnny Cash wears on stage?
Black, because he was known as the Man in Black. Amazing what you find. Going across, he is a bit, isn't he?
First admit on January 1st, 1970.
What did you what? Hello? What did?
What did? First admit on January 1st, 1970.
What did what admit?
First admit on January 1st, 1970. Some kind of. Market crash.
Lloyd's first admit.
Yeah.
Doesn't it mean like people to a place? It's like women to their boardroom or something like that. Okay, we'll read the answer because it's got to be the last one this time.
To the boardroom
of the company, wouldn't it? It's an old school,
organization.
1970. It's a business establishment, you know.
1970.
Clean country.
No. Jesus Christ.
Okay, one more. You have to ask me one more question because I've got them right or at least half right, apart from the peaks thing.
What monthly is subtitled Entertainment for Men?
Playboy.
Playboy.
Well, how do you know about that?
Because it's the kind of question they would have.
Where
in trouble
are
pursuit.
The convolutions of
The what? Convolutions of Broca? I don't know. In Broca? I don't know, Ireland, Northern Ireland, Easter Ireland. I don't know. What?
In the brain.
In the brain. Oh, I see. Stuff that I don't know. Thank you very much, Quizmaster.
What must remain on the floor in the snooker?
Sorry?
What must remain on the floor in the snooker?
1 foot.
Okay.
Yeah.
Why does it have to be 1 foot?
Because you can have the other foot up as you lean over the table. Okay. Say bye to the camera.
Bye, camera.
Bye, camera. Okay. Thank you very much, Quizmaster.